Hi. God bless. God bless. Come on in. You know what time it is? You say it's a praise break. That'll be in a couple of hours, 9:30. But this time for the radio show with yours truly, Pastor Darlene Bell, Pastor Sarah, and Evangelist Derrick. So don't go anywhere. So you come on in and woo, we are ready to rock and roll for Jesus. Amen. Woo. And this song, of course, that's playing, we don't own the rights to it. But I love it, long as I got King Jesus. Woo! Hallelujah. Long as I got King Jesus, yeah. Woo! Yeah! God bless you, Evangelist Sarah Bell has come into the radio showroom. Amen. Don't go too far, my friend. She says, praise the Lord. Oh, we got a good word. Here we go.
Inspiration from 1440 AM, Reborn, WMKM. It is now time for the exciting Life Radio broadcast with your hosts, Darlene and Sarah, and your special guest hosts, Minister Derrick, Mr. Dress Up Taylor, right here on AM 1440.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Exciting Life Christian Center. Yes, brought to you from Exciting Life Christian Center, where yours truly are the pastors, Dr. Pastor Darlene Bell and Dr. Pastor Sarah Riddle-Taylor. Live in the studios are, of course, myself, Pastor Darlene. Who else is in here tonight? Who else is in the studio? Who's on the radio show?
Pastor Sarah Riddle.
And Minister Derrick Dressup Taylor.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Listen, God bless you all. And I'm going to start the word off, and then we're going to turn the tailors loose on tonight. Listen, we're so glad to be here on this snowy day. Those of you, maybe you're not in Michigan, but Michigan, we had some snow, but it's so beautiful out. The snow reminds us that the Lord will wash us white as snow. Well, listen, I'd like to give a couple of announcements. Of course, we are, as I stated, the co-pastors of Excite Life Christian Center. Right now, our services are going by way of virtuality. Amen. You can check out the Church Flow Exciting Life Christian Center Church Flow on Darlene Bell's page, live on Facebook every Sunday, 1 p.m. And of course, we're here every Wednesday, 7:30, 7:45 on the number one station, 1440 a.m. WMKM. Amen. God bless you, DJ Brenda's in the house. Woo! Amen. So listen, and I also want to invite you to continue to watch Darlene and Sarah Gospel Spectacular TV show, which airs on Comcast every Sunday. If you're in East Oakland or Macomb County's 8 o'clock AM channel 90 or Detroit 6:30 PM channel 20. If you don't have Comcast, don't worry. No problem. No issues. You can get tune in our shows daily on Bell Global Network. That's BGNTVGospel.com. That is my second oldest son and his wife's wonderful network. And talking about that, if you're a minister, you feel, well, I think I want to go a little higher to get out the boat, get my own TV show. Those of you on Facebook, yeah, go to Anton Choir Boy Bell page. Tell him that his mama and his auntie sent you. You'll get a discount. Amen and amen. Listen, my friends, come on in. We're also going Facebook Live. God bless Evangelist Sarah Bell, my youngest daughter. She says, praise the Lord. She says, you look cute, Mom. Thank you, Mike. What is my fashion consultant, concierge? Evangelist Sarah, you got me this cute little top. That was another one of my Valentine's Day. Thank you, Sarah. It is cute. Amen. Listen, I just want to get this word started on tonight to encourage you. You don't have to be hopeless or downtrodden or feel like you just in this world by yourself. Even more than ever, this is the time not to run away from God, but to draw nigh to God. It's too much going around in the atmosphere for you to even think about it. This is a time, you know, it seemed like a lot of people, God kind of put a pause button on a lot of things. Look, that's a good time to settle down and spend more time with God. Amen. So I'm getting another excerpt from one of my sermons, and the excerpt taken is from God Hears and Answers Prayers. I want you to get your Bibles if you have them or in your apps. Psalm 65:2 says, "Thou that hearest prayers, unto thee shall all flesh come." Don't ever be ashamed to come to the Lord. God, you talk to God about any and everything. He is your best friend. You don't have to worry about him spreading it on social media or putting it in a newspaper. It is between you and the God, you and the Lord. And it says, "Thou, O Lord, you hear prayer, and all flesh shall come unto you." Luke 1:13 says, "Fear not, thy prayer is heard." And he was talking to Zechariah. Zechariah just doing business as usual as a priest in the temple. That's why continue to be about God's business. If you take care of God's business, guess what? Woo, glory to God, he's going to take care of yours. And Elizabeth and Zacharias have been praying for a baby. They were beyond childbearing years. But one day, when Zechariah's least expected it, somebody type that down. When you least expect it, God is going to come up. He's going to surprise you. God get ready to surprise somebody. He's been surprising some of you with some blessing. But God said, "I'm not finished. I got some more, some more blessings." Amen. I'm going to give one more verse. Then we're going to turn the tailors loose. Amen. 1 John 5:14-15. Go back and eat it up later. This is the confidence we have in him. That's why we go boldly to the throne of grace. If we ask anything according to his will, you may say, "Well, what is his will?" That's why you have to just keep staying in the word. Keep, you know, going to good Bible-believing churches. Find out what his will is. If we ask anything according to his will, his word is his will. He hears us. He hears us. Amen. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desired of him. See, because when you're praying according to the will of God, you're going to pray according to his will. If you're praying according to the word of God, you're going to pray according to his will. One little thing, his will is for you to be healthy, whole, set free. Jesus Christ said, "I come to give you life that more abundantly." He said he was wounded for your transgression, bruised for your iniquity. Chastisement of my peace was upon you, was upon him. Chastisement of our peace, let me get it right, was upon him. With his stripes, we are healed. Psalms 103 says he heals all of our diseases. And also he says God has not given us a spirit of fear, power, love, and a sound mind. So if you need healing, know it's God's will for you to be healed. Baby, it's a done deal. God bless Cousin D. Brooks. Evander Sarah Bell says, "Amen, good word, Mom, and unexpected." God, get ready to give somebody some more unexpected blessings. Come on, Taylor. Come on, Taylors.
Word.
Yes.
I just want to talk a little bit, of course, of one of my favorite books, the third epistle of John.
Woo.
We know that God wants us to prosper and be in health.
Yes.
But our souls prosper when we're in the word of God. And we don't, you know, and I love the 11th verse. It says, "Don't imitate that which is evil. Why would that be your leader or your guide?" It says, "But that which is good is our God."
Yes.
And so, if you know, when we imitate the Lord, we are drawing somebody to the kingdom of God.
Yes.
We don't go out here full of foolishness and acting like the devil himself. Because the Lord is our Savior and our God. We are not ashamed of the gospel.
Yes.
Of Jesus Christ. And so, I was going to say, beloved, I pray that you prosper. So it's a, what is this about? I don't need it. No, the Bible says pray that you prosper in what? All things.
All things, yes.
Everything in your life,
yes.
We pray, God, bless my body, my mind, my spirit.
Bless God, yes. No. Come on now. Yes.
So we are not defeated, but we are a people of gain.
Yes.
Gain because we are in the Lord. Amen. Praise God for warm and blessings flow. Amen. Minister Kate.
Yes.
We have to know as Christians, we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus.
More than conquerors.
That's right.
You know, every day that you get up and God allows you to see a new day.
Yeah.
Don't you know that God has given you the power to speak those things that are not as though they were?
Come on now.
Those things that are not is what God has given us to stand on.
Yes.
We are more than conquerors over every situation. Woo. In life. We say, Jesus said we can do all things through him.
Yes.
That's right.
So if you can do all things through Christ, that makes you more than a conqueror. Not just a conqueror, but more than a conqueror. That means you can go further than what your mind can conceive.
Yes.
So you have to remember, in everything, whether it's a small thing, whether it's a large thing, whether it's a mountain-type situation,
yes,
God has given you the power,
yes,
to overcome.
Mm-hmm. The tailors are cooking with gas on tonight. Let me acknowledge a couple of more Facebook people. God bless you, D. Brooks' cousin have joined us. God bless Aaron Gladman. And Evangelist Sarah Bell says, unexpected blessings and miracles. That's what God is giving somebody on tonight. And listen, if you're driving in your car, you listen to the car radio, maybe you may need to pull over, lift your hand, say, Lord, I receive. I believe I receive, Lord, just all the blessings that you have for me. Unexpected miracle blessings coming through right now. Evangelist Sarah Bell said, I believe, receive it. Deep Brooks says, it's all God. Evangelist Sarah Bell says, hallelujah. Aaron Gladman say, hi, Pastor Darlene and Pastor Sarah. Hey, man of God, Aaron Gladman. Listen, just to go back to a little bit what I was talking about at the beginning, that God hears and he answers prayers. God does not have on cotton in his ears, my friend. You are a child of God. He is your daddy, but you pray according to the will of God. Everything that's being said on here is to encourage you. So you got to lay hold. You got to latch on to all this goodness that's been shared, all this faith. Keep the faith. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Matthew 7:7 in the Amplified says, keep on asking and it will be given you. You don't just have to ask one time. Never give up. Stop focusing on the issue, situation, circumstance, or problems. You know that God is bigger than any problem. That's what we have to always realize. Ephesians 3:20 says, not unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that any of us could even ask or think, according to the power that works within us. So little prayer, little power. Much prayer, much power. That's why we have to keep your spiritual tank edified. Amen. Keep it built up. Keep it full of God's oil. I'm going to say one more thing, then we're going to get back to the tellers. Psalm 55:16, as for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall save me. Verse 16, evening, morning, at noon will I pray, cry aloud. Amen. Tell God all about it. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. It says, evening, morning, and at noon will I pray, cry aloud. He shall hear my voice. Now, let me tell you this. God is not a genie in a bottle. You know, you don't just control him. He's Lord. So he moves in his own timing, how he wants to do it, and in the way. But it's just up to us to submit ourselves, surrender. But I tell you, like I said at the beginning, this is the season. Get closer to the Lord. What's too much going around the atmosphere, don't run further. Baby, draw closer. And if you draw nigh to God, he'll draw nigh to you. Come on, tell us just a little bit more. Amen.
Well, I say, my, what a mighty good word.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
And so when we do that, we will be straight up. And I love John Corp. That's my favorite book.
Yes.
It says in 11th verse, beloved, do not imitate what is evil, but what is good. He who has does good is of God.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right.
Thank God for how he's leading us.
Yes.
And how he's guiding us. And his word is so pure.
Yes.
Elaborated in the word. Listen, Derrick elaborates. I elaborate.
Yes.
Grab hold.
Amen. Well, listen. It's probably, listen, I'm going to have to write, shall see God. Amen. Right now, I'm looking. Amen. Yes. Amen. Amen. Well, listen, Pastor Sarah, this, it is 7:40. Well, it's 7:45. We're going to say a quick prayer and then we off. Just say, Lord Jesus, I repent of my sin. Come in my life. Come in my heart. Save me. Right now, I forgive you of all my sins. In Jesus' name, amen. You're my Lord and my Savior. God bless you, Cherry Gray. God bless everybody that tuned in to another show. This has been Pastor Dr. Darlene Bell.
Dress up in the armor of the Lord.
Yes. God bless.
Thank you for tuning in to another broadcast of Exciting Life with your hosts, Darlene and Sarah. And
okay, Reverend Bell, that was beautiful. I'll talk to you next week.
Yes, thank you, Brenda. Have a blessed, blessed week, DJ.
Yes, and you do the same.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Mm-hmm. Woo, listen, Facebook family and friends, I'm going to hang out with you a few more moments. Woo, that was a very good show. Take everything in, you know, and be consistent in your walk with the Lord. Because if you're not consistent, ask God, say, Lord, help me to be consistent. But once again, shout out to all the ones that's hanging out with me now on Facebook Live, Evangelist Sarah, my youngest daughter, Dee Brooks, cousin, amen, amen. Erin Gladman has stopped by, and Sherry Gray, my spiritual daughter. God bless all of Exciting Life Christian Center members and supporters. God bless all my co-laborers in the Lord, my children, Antonio, his family, Antone, Yolanda, China. Happy birthday, China. Her birthday was yesterday, my granddaughter. Woo! Let's see, shout out to Marietta Ron, Samia Naya, Elena, Sophia, the twins. Shout out to Angelo Brandes, Giselle, and the newest Grand Bambino, Granny's firstborn grandson, Gavin Lee, Antonio Bell. And shout out to Dre Bell Rock, and last but not least, Evangelist Sarah Bell. Amen. So God bless everybody for tuning in. I tell you, my friend, look for those unexpected surprises, unexpected miracles, unexpected blessing. God is getting ready to just do something that's going to put an extra, extra smile on your face. Keep seeking him. Keep loving him. Keep spending time with him. As you love God, he'll love you back. The Bible says you draw nigh to him. See how close I'm getting? On the Facebook, see? You draw, that's how God's face is going to get to you. Amen. You draw close to God. He's going to draw close to you. But look at this. You draw way back. Way back. Look at this. God, Lord, don't let me tip over. And then you moved away from God. Amen. He's not going to leave you. God bless my oldest daughter, Marietta Elliott. Thank you for stopping by. Sarah Bell is lifting up those holy hands. Amen. Listen, I will be back, help me say, tonight, 9:30 Eastern Standard Time. Amen. This is Thursday. No, this is Wednesday. Amen. February 17th. Happy birthday to my spiritual son, Franklin. Amen. So we got these nice little February birthdays. My granddaughter, China Doll. And then my spiritual son, Brother Franklin. Amen. Listen, God bless everybody. Ooh, know that the best is on the way. Where are my VIPs? I want to see you tonight. Ooh, VIPs will be in the house. VIPs, yes, very intense praisers praising God. Ooh, I love you, but God loves you more. Amen. I'll see you later.